What are some of the great enemies of the Christian faith? The things that distract us from walking with Christ? Well, first of all, know this. You're living in a world, most of us are awake about 16 hours a day, in a world that is constantly bombarding us with that which is not true. Not only that, but bombarding us with distractions. Not just evil things, but even good things that are used at times to take us away from the most excellent things. And what is the most excellent thing? Our growth in the knowledge of Jesus Christ and the deepening of our love for God in Him. Now, so there's distractions, constant distractions. And there are things pulling on us. And then we must also realize that the Bible does teach that there is a person called the devil, and that there are fallen angels called demons. And yes, they are also constantly laboring to get the Christian off track. Now, when we think about getting the Christian off track, we may be thinking about that the Christian falls into some gross sin, and that can happen. But the way in which the devil most works against our soul is to make us apathetic, to get us looking in the wrong direction, to get us thinking about things that aren't the most important eternal things. And the question is, how can we avoid this? Well, if I'm in the world 16 hours a day awake, and for 16 hours a day the world is bombarding me with its distractions and its falsehoods, and I'm in the Word of God no time at all, of course I'm going to lose the battle of the mind. So what must I do? You must come to the conviction that you cannot walk with God apart from renewing your mind in the Word of God and prayer. I've been a preacher for many, many years, and yet I'm only as spiritual as my devotional life today. This morning, before I came to make this film or the other busy activities I had to do, I had to be in the Word, and I had to pray. Because I know that apart from having my mind renewed in the Word of God, apart from being strengthened by the Holy Spirit through prayer, I'm simply not going to be able to walk with Him. Now, another thing that is very important, when we study the Scriptures, that we might be pleasing to God, it's not just a sense of, I need to learn some principles or rules. I study the Scriptures primarily to see Him, to see Christ. Because you see, the more I see of Jesus Christ in the Scriptures, the more my affections are going to be drawn out and given to Him. And the more He has my affections, the more He has my heart. And the more He has my heart, the less I'm going to be distracted with the things of this world. Now, many preachers would tell you this, you need to love God more. And you would probably say, yes. But the question is, how? How do we grow in our love for God? Well, let me give you an illustration. I love my wife now more than when I met her 22 years ago. And why do I love her more? Because over these 22 years, I've seen more of her virtue, more of the good that is in her, that God has put in her. I see the beauty of her spirituality. I see the beauty of her virtue. Now, so that beauty that I see, those virtues that I see, they draw out my affections and make me more devoted to her. Now let's apply this to the Christian life. How can I love God more so that I'm not apathetic, so that I'm not drawn into the world? I love Him more by seeing more about Him. One of the greatest needs in the church today is for preachers to preach on who is God, to put before God's people the beauty and the power of His attributes. One of the greatest needs you have as a Christian is to get into the Word of God, to discover who is this God. And I can assure you that the more you see of Him, the less you will desire to see of the world. A lot of times when Christians are having trouble growing or having trouble with apathy, they'll read a book on 5 ways to free themselves from apathy or 10 principles to live the Christian life. Most of that doesn't help. What you need is a greater knowledge of God through the study of the Scriptures, and that will propel you into a more devoted lifestyle.